This conference will now be recorded.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Good morning. Hi. Good morning.
Yeah. Hi. Good morning. This is Kirti.
Yeah. Hi. This is Kumar here. Able to see my screen?
Yes, Kumar. Yes.
Okay. So before I start for the service now. Just a demonstration. Just want to know any idea on ServiceNow, or have you worked on ServiceNow or any other ITSM tool?
Yes, I just went through a crash course on this ServiceNow. I didn't work on it.
Okay.
I just went. It was just like a crash course. So I just want to know, like, in detail. I mean, much more about the things in that.
Okay. So what I will do, I can, okay, one more person is joining. Give me one more minute.
Okay.
Hi Snehit, good morning. So what I can do, I'll just go through a slide on ServiceNow, why we are using ServiceNow, what are the benefits of using ServiceNow, why so many companies are moving to ServiceNow nowadays. And then I will go with the contents, what are the contents I am sharing for ITSM, the admin and developments.
Okay.
So moving to this slide. So this is called a ServiceNow Enterprise IT Cloud Company. So before that, I will just give an introduction of mine. So I'm working in ServiceNow from past 6 years. I'm working as a ServiceNow consultant. I have been working on ServiceNow admin development and integration. I have a total of 11 years of IT experience, in which almost 6 years into ServiceNow. And this is a small introduction of mine. So let's start with a slide. So ServiceNow Enterprise IT Cloud Company, what does it mean? When ServiceNow started in 2012, it was just called an ServiceNow Cloud Company, but now ServiceNow is called an Enterprise IT Cloud Company. That means ServiceNow has moved its business into different segments. So we have different types of modules in ServiceNow. We have HR module, marketing, finance. So different types of models. We have ITSM, ITOM. That's why we call this ServiceNow as an Enterprise IT Cloud Company. Okay. Moving to the next slide again. So Enterprise IT Cloud Company, it's a auto ITSM tool that automates the enterprise IT operation, and founded in 2004 by Fred Lady. And ServiceNow is an example of a PaaS where platform is also supplied along with customer to develop the OOB functionality. Okay, so when you talk about ServiceNow, it's an ITSM tool. When you talk about ServiceNow, it's an ITSM tool that is called IT Service Management, and it was founded in 2004 by Fred Lady, and it's an example of PaaS. So cloud computing, we have infrastructure as services, platform as a services, and software as a services. Here ServiceNow provides platform as a services. That means it's giving all its platform to its customer, along with the admin, development, integration, production, everything into one instance. You don't require any additional software to work on ServiceNow. Okay.
Okay.
Moving to the next slide. Things you should know, what is ServiceNow, version of ServiceNow, enterprise processes, cloud, ITSM, and ITL. What is ServiceNow and benefits of ServiceNow? ServiceNow is the leading provider of cloud-based IT services that automates enterprise IT operations. ServiceNow is a powerful and versatile cloud-based IT services, ITSM platform that support incident, problem, change, and knowledge management. So whatever you can see over here, incident, problem, and change, knowledge management, this has all been taken from ITL framework. We are using the ITL framework over here in ServiceNow. Not only in ServiceNow, we are using HPSM, BMC Remedy. All are based on ITL best practices. Even ServiceNow is also using the ITL best practices. Benefits of ServiceNow: on-demand IT service management, governance functions, guaranteed performance, availability, continuity of the services, and data confidentiality and integrity. So because of so many benefits, most of the company, almost all companies are moving to ServiceNow nowadays. So versions of ServiceNow, you can see we have started from 2011, almost it is a 2012. Aspen, Berlin, Calgary. So currently we are working on Madrid, London, and Kingston. Most of the companies are working on these three. Jakarta, April 18 is the last day for Jakarta. After that, no one will be able to work on Jakarta. Kingston, London, Madrid. Again, you can see in the graph, we have New York, which is going to get released in Q3 for 2019. Again, for this next year, we have Orlando, which is going to get released, Orlando and Paris. So what is the difference between this, whatever London we are using, Madrid, New York, or Kingston? Let's see in the next slide. You can see the difference of Jakarta, Kingston, London, Istanbul, Helsinki, and Geneva. Starting from the Kingston. Kingston works on artificial intelligence. We can see so many, right now everything is artificial intelligence now. So Kingston works, you can integrate your Facebook, Google I/O with your ServiceNow Kingston. London, again, works on Agile and Scrum. We have the Agile and Scrum module in London. Madrid, we are using the automation. So different types of features they have come with in different types of module. Again, you can see in Kingston, artificial intelligence, flow design, MIM, that is called major incident management, service mapping, configuration, HR module they have included in Kingston. Moving to the London, again, virtual agent, inside explorer, work experience, continual improvement services. So these are the new features they have come with different types of modules. What are the enterprise process? So you can see this, the graph, the whatever you can see over here, the life cycle of ITL service management. This has been taken from IT's best practices, ITL best practices. We have incident management, problem change management, service level management, service request management system, CI, that is called configuration item, assets, workflow, and applications. Okay, any doubt, any question till now?
No, Kumar, fine.
Moving to the next slide. This is a general overview of cloud computing, how cloud computing is connected to the customer side. We have LBS provider, we have Echo and Dev tool, cloud platform we are using. By this, we are using connected to the customer side within by software as a services, platform as a services, and infrastructure as a services. Moving to the next slide, ServiceNow and the ITL framework. As you can see, ServiceNow is an IT service management that follows the ITL V3 framework, but now ServiceNow is currently expanding its footprint into many other portfolios such as legal management, marketing, cost management, and so on. So right now, as I told you, we are using ServiceNow in different types of module, ITL module in ServiceNow. So again, ITL module of V3, we are working on service design, transaction, operation, and strategy. If you go with ITL module, we have five life cycle. That is called design, transaction, operation, strategy, and improvement. Your incident and problem comes under the service operations. Your service, your change management comes under your service transaction. So we have a different life cycle of ITL. So based on that, we are working on service improvement. And now you can see ServiceNow uses the ITL framework, platform as applications, designing, and architecture. Benefits of ServiceNow hosted in the cloud based on the ITL: customizable data confidentiality, improved operational tracking, continuity of services, on-demand IT service management, customer self services, and powerful reporting. continuing the same slide, continuing quicker time to system availability, no capital expenditure, and all fundamental ideal, including purchase licensing. So no capital expenditure, however, requires ongoing operational budget. That means, as of now, if any of the company organization of any of your project is looking for orchestration or discovery, they can go and request for orchestration. Orchestration is the costliest module of ServiceNow. They don't provide free to its customer. You need to pay extra for that to work on that particular module. All fundamental ITIL module, including post-seat licensing. That means how many licenses you are looking for. Based on that, you need to request a ServiceNow. Development, test, production, newer design and architecture. You can do your own development, test, and production in a single instance. You don't require any additional software, any additional instance to work on. And you can design as per whatever you have requirement. Based on integration, you can do any type of integration like SAP tool, Oracle database. You can integrate your ServiceNow. Moving to the next slide, features of ServiceNow. It's a simple and consistent, flexible, secure, lower total cost, easy to integrate, and speed time production. It's very simple to use, flexible. You can use different types of workflow over here. Security, when it comes about say data security, it's very secure. Lower total cost compared to other ITSM tools. The cost of ServiceNow is very minimal. Easy to integrate. You can integrate any third-party tool to your ServiceNow with the help of a mid server and LDAP. Speed time production. If you are going to do any type of activity or any uploading or downloading any data from ServiceNow, you can see that the downloads is into the millisecond. Again, backup and recovery. So ServiceNow maintains 7 daily and 3 weekly backups. So whatever the activity you are doing every day in your organization, so all the backups are taken care by ServiceNow. Even your organization is also taking care of your activity. Even your ServiceNow also take care of the backup of your whatever the activity you are performing. Any questions, any doubt?
No, Kumar.
Moving to the next slide. So yeah, features of service. Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah. Sorry to interrupt. I was just checking whether my voice is audible to you guys. Anyways, continue, yeah. Kumar. It's good. Thank you.
Thank you. So features of ServiceNow, again, as I told you, ServiceNow is available in your desktop as well as in your mobile. You can access your ServiceNow from your mobile also, unless and until you are connected to the internet. So strategy, design, transaction, operation, and build. So these are, you can access your ServiceNow from BlackBerry, Android, tablets, anywhere. Moving to the next slide. So this is a basic architecture of the ServiceNow, how ServiceNow is connected to the customer side. We have SSL, that is called service socket layout, web server, J2E application, database, load balancer, Apache. So this is how ServiceNow is connected to the customer. The Linux server, with a Linux or Windows server, we are connected. Why we are using ServiceNow? ServiceNow provides 99.9% availability. IT service management framework add-ons give us the liberty to customize instance and integrate the instance with different tools and server as per customer requirement. ServiceNow is a cloud-based application. We do not need to take care of servers and infrastructure. ServiceNow regularly check up performance of your instance and make changes in infrastructure. Okay, ServiceNow regularly check up the performance. That means you can see we have n number of plugins where we are working on in ServiceNow. So right now we are into 1.1 and they are working on some in that particular plugin to 2.0. They have upgraded to 2.0. Now they will notify its customer that you can upgrade your plugin to 2.0 to get the better experience of your work. Moving to the next slide, modules we have. So service desk, incident management, problem, change, configuration, SLM, knowledge management, CMDB, integration, discovery, reporting, and analytics. So these are the modules where we are working on our ITSM. Everything is included, incident, change, configuration, everything is included over here in your ServiceNow instance. Move to the next slide again. Who uses ServiceNow? Employees, the person who requests for an incident. IT support staff, the person who create an incident. Administrator, the person who works on incident or in your ServiceNow instance. Implementer, who deploys different types of tools with you in your ServiceNow. And the developer, who is writing the scripting over here, defining the scripting based on the UI request. That is called user interface. Okay. Employees, IT support staff, admin, implementer, and developer. This data is for my 2016. You can see Facebook. We are in 2019. N number of companies added in ServiceNow. So 2016 onwards, you can see Facebook, Twitter, Qualcomm, Johnson & Johnson, American Express, Netflix. They are using ServiceNow. Capgemini. IBM Capgemini is a co-partner of ServiceNow. Even your Dell also. Dell, IBM, they are a co-partner of ServiceNow. Even right now, Amazon, Flipkart, they are using ServiceNow. From the telecom sector, your Airtel, Vodafone, they are using ServiceNow in the backend. Recently, Canara Bank, they have implemented ServiceNow in their work in the backend. Okay, any doubt, any question? Moving to the next slide. So you can see the job market of ServiceNow, which is started in 2012 and till 2016, how the job market is going up day by day. Moving to the next slide, Indeed, which I have taken from Indeed, the salary structure. So you can see how they are paying to the professionals. So ServiceNow admin, developer, consultant, developer, admin, administrator, banking sector, architect. So these are salary structure of ServiceNow. Okay. Moving to my contents, what are the contents I'll be sharing inside for the ServiceNow? Okay, this is the contents for the admin. I have admin development and integration overview. Moving to the admin again, introduction to ServiceNow, what is ServiceNow, helpful portal, release, form, list, and tables. Then I will have a session on ServiceNow on ITL. So before working on ServiceNow, you should know, understand the ITL concept of general ITL concept, what is incident, problem, change, knowledge management, CMDB, why we are using the CMDB. Just a general overview I will give you on ITL. Then I will go with a configure the groups and roles, how to create a users, roles, and groups, how to assign that particular users to that particular roles and groups. Basic form and list modification, how to personalize your form, your list, your fields, how to design your form. Plugins again, what is the plugins, how to work on plugins, how to activate or upgrade your plugins. Clearing the ServiceNow caches, ServiceNow database cache is something how you're deleting the temporary files from your internet, going to the cookies and deleting all the temporary files. Likewise, the same thing, we have something called cache where you are going to delete all the temporary files from your ServiceNow. Then how to remove the attachment from incident, problem, and change. Moving to the next column number five. Sale number five. So applications and modules, how to create an applications, how to create your own modules in ServiceNow. Update set, what is an update set? Update set is something moving any configurational changes from one instance to another instance. Like currently I'm working on London. I want to move whatever the applications module I have created in my ServiceNow to my London. So with the help of update set, I will move everything. Now, second scenario is, as a development admin, I have created any applications module. Now how to move to the production? So with the help of an update set, I will move to the testing. Then from the testing, I will move to the production. So everything will be discussed on update set. Move to the SLM, how to create an SLA, that is called service level agreement, operational level agreement, and underpinning contract. in your ServiceNow, how to create a workflow, how to create a conditions on that workflow. Using the retro restart option, we have retro restart option. What is retro restart option? ACL, how to secure your applications from your unauthorized user. Service catalog, how to create a catalog, how to create a variables and variable set, creating the workflow, how to work on record producer. The same thing, workflow, creating and attaching the workflow into your SLA and service catalog. Scheduling the job and import, how to import your any external file to your ServiceNow with the help of a transform map using the transform script. Again, we have a UI policy, how to create a UI, what is UI is a user interface, how to create an UI policy, defining the UI policy in different ways, service catalog UI policy, switching between UI 15 and UI 16. Currently, every companies are working on UI 16. No one is working on UI 15. That is called user interface. Branding your own instance, creating your custom homepage. How to create your own ServiceNow instance with your company logo when you come designing the whole ServiceNow as per your business requirement, your company requirement. User admin and security, groups and roles, email notification, user preference, ACL security roles. Email notification is something, okay, so any priority one ticket is created. Automatically, an email will be sent to your management, to your client that there is your P1 ticket created. So what I will do over here, I will configure my Gmail and I can send any email from my ServiceNow. So if any ticket is created, automatically I will be receiving an email from ServiceNow in my Gmail ID. ServiceNow knowledge management, how to create a knowledge articles, what is service knowledge management, what is the category, how to define the category and create a category. Then CMDB, which is a very important topic of ServiceNow. It's not only in ServiceNow we are using, every company is using CMDB. Without CMDB, they cannot perform the business. So same thing we are going to discuss over here. We have one-to-many relationship in ServiceNow, many-to-many relationship that is called a parents and child relationship. Defining the custom relationship, defining the table inheritance, CI relationship, we have something called business service map, how to create a business service map, CMDB schema, and finally, we have something called service portal, creating the widgets, service portal components, everything. So there are 16 topics which will be discussed on your admin. Any questions, any doubts from your side? Kritika or Raj?
Yeah, hi Kumar. I just have a doubt. So the modules, what all you explained, the 16 modules. So do we need scripting knowledge to do all this? I mean, the JavaScript.
See, I've just talked about admin. Then I have a development where I require scripting knowledge. That is, it's not a high-end JavaScripting you are required. Yes, it's a basic JavaScript you require to understand the operator functions we are using. So anyway, I'll be discussing.
Apart from that, we can. You can just operate the administration using all these modules, right? Like without doing the JavaScript.
Yes. You can use that. That's why I have defined.
After the JavaScript, we can just fork it from GitHub, right? Like, is that any possible, or do we need an in-depth knowledge of that?
See, it's not an end-to-end knowledge of JavaScript required. Yes, basic knowledge you should have. So anyway, I will be guiding you on the JavaScript also. So once I start with my admin, parallelly I will go and I will give some document on JavaScript, and I will have some. We have some W3 schools, right, where you can learn the JavaScript. Parallelly. So once I start my development, it will be easy for you to understand the whatever the functions we are using in JavaScript.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And where do we get the dictionary entry and dictionary overrides, Kumar? Like in the admin side only?
Yeah, in the admin side.
Okay. So yeah, I didn't see in these modules. And do you explain us on cloning part also?
See, cloning part comes under your item. Anyway, I will give you an overview heads up on cloning part.
Yeah, okay. So this is only for ITOM?
This is ITSM. What we are discussing now, this is ITSM.
Okay. So that comes under ITOM, right? The cloning
yes.
thing?
Yes.
Okay.
So anyway, I will just give you an overview of ITOM also. So this is that section topic which will be discussed on your admin. Moving to the development again. To script, not to script. Again, we have client-side API. Client-side, we have a 4 API, onload, on change, on submit, and on sell edit. Server-side, we have so many APIs. The server-side, glide date and time, glide system user, glide Ajax, glide gform. Server-side scripting, dot working, script rules, and business rules. Client-side scripting, we have client-side compatibility, built-up performance, UI script, and script from this server. Okay, and moving to the debugging again, client-side debugging, server-side debugging, business rules, ACL, and background script. So these are the six topics which will be discussed on your development. All the business rule, script rule, dot workings, everything I have included over here. Any doubt, any questions on this development topic?
No, should be fine.
Moving to my integration overview. So I have again integration, how to create an integration, type of writing integration. Orchestration, how to create your own meet server, IP address, DNS names, default defining the meet server. So anytime, whenever you are doing the integration, the first thing you require a meet server and LDAP to communicate between your ServiceNow and your any external applications. So again, we have a LDAP integration, authentication, listener, importing users from the LDAP server. I have a testing website, testing tool with me, where I will import all my users into my ServiceNow with the help of an LDAP. Again, domain separation. Organizing the domain, defining the domain, creating domain relationship. Discovery, data collected from the discovery, domain separation, creating the discovery. So these are the five models which will be including, which will be worked on this ITSM.
Yeah, and Kumar, just one last question.
Yeah.
So do you explain the modules using, I mean, in the testing and all, using the Madrid version or the London one?
I have a London one. Madrid is still they are doing some upgrades and working on Madrid now in the test demo instance. So right now I'm not using the Madrid now.
Because in a Madrid version, they have introduced a mobile studio, right? Which is to develop applications in ServiceNow. So wouldn't you be teaching that also?
The mobile version is not only in Madrid. It has started from your Istanbul.
We need to script and develop the applications. But mobile in Madrid is just like drag and drop, right?
Yes.
So wouldn't you be explaining in this? I mean, in this whole training.
Both the mobile versions and the desktop version I will be using.
I mean, wouldn't be explaining me the mobile studio? How does it work and how do you implement in real life?
Yeah, yeah.
So
I'll be working on that.
Is it interesting? That's what I meant.
Yeah, yeah. Mobile as well as desktop, both I will cover.
No, I mean, I'm just asking that in the Madrid version, there's a mobile studio, right? So would you be explaining about the mobile studio in detail? Because now I'm working for a company. They asked me to learn about ServiceNow, and the main requirement is using mobile studio. I have to develop applications, but I really have a lot of time to learn all this. So I really want, I mean, if it's possible, it could be included in this training.
Yeah, I will be including. The mobile app, mobile studio.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, So these are the three things, three admin development and integration will be covering in your ITSM. Okay. Moving to my, so you are looking for ITOM, right, as well?
Yes, I'm looking for both.
Oh, one sec, I'll just open my ITOM contents. So apart from this thing, whatever the topic I'll be discussing on, I'll be sharing all the PDF document on this with real-time scenario I'll be using. So moving to the item again, we have a CMDB designing. We have around 7 stages how to define your CMDB. We have LDAP again, understanding the integration LDAP. Again, we have a mid-server, installing the configuring the mid-server. Cloud management, we have a setup guide of AWS, Azure, VMware, CAPI, cloud management troubleshooting, and cloud user portal. Here in cloud management, I'll be using the AWS because I have a AWS license with me. I don't have the Azure and VMware, so I will just give you how to work on how to set up Azure and VMware with your ServiceNow, because I don't have those paid license for me, Azure and VMware. I have only for AWS. Will be that fine for cloud management topic?
Okay.
Because Azure is very costly.
Okay.
For taking the license. Azure okay. And okay. So I have a AWS. Moving to the service mapping, we have understanding the service mapping setup, application service mapping, application service completion, plan activation services. Again, we have event management, understanding event management, implementing event management, alert aggregating and RCA, monitoring alerts. Orchestration, we have introduction to orchestration, domain separation orchestration, activation of orchestration, and discovery, basic setup, configuration, and troubleshooting. So there are 8 topics which will be covered in your ITOM.
Okay, the SOAP and REST.
See, SOAP and REST API, right? That comes under the web services, which will be discussed on your ITSM only.
Okay.
Sorry, Kumar, but I'm like really new for the service now. I just have basic knowledge. What is the difference between ITSM and ITOM? I mean,
ITSM is IT service management. ITOM, IT is under ITSM, we have admin development in this thing, integration. Okay. ITOM, we are going to define each into like we are doing any type of mapping. Like we have a CI and asset, right? Configuration, how to create a configuration item, how to map that configuration item with that particular business services. We have n number of CI we are using in our day-to-day activity, day-to-day life. So how to configure that CI with that particular asset. So those things come under the item, how to integrate in depth, those things comes under the item. How you are going to operate that particular applications with your ServiceNow in different method.
Okay, does the administrator use the item as well, like he'll...
Right now, in few projects they are using. Because everywhere is cost cutting, right? So they ask the administrator to learn ITOM also.
But it's not like major requirement, right?
No, it's not a major requirement. Yes,
okay.
They will ask for doing the integration, any type of integration.
Okay, so majorly like only ITSM is used, like being a service.
Yes, ITSM is mandatory. Whatever the topics I am covering, it's based on ITSM. ITOM, the person who is already experienced on ITSM, they are looking for the ITOM. But yes, if you are looking for ITOM, you should understand the ITSM concept.
Okay.
Yep. And it will be for you. Yeah.
Just carry on. I'm sorry.
So whatever the topics I have covered based on the ITSM, you can go on iTome, because the same thing, even what I have done over here, few people are looking for the integration. So for that, I have defined how to create an integration. I have included a few topics of iTome over here also. So at least if someone asks you to create a Meet Server LDAP, then you can go ahead and create the LDAP and Meet Server, which is used to communication purpose.
Okay. And
Yeah, please tell me.
Okay. Yeah, you said you'll be using the London version, right?
Yes, London. So, Kingston and London both, because we have something called update set, right? So for update set, I'll be using the Kingston and London.
Okay. So what would be the difference, like will there be a major difference between this London and Madrid? Because I just started working on the Madrid instance. So when I go back to the London, can I map it to this?
Yes, you can see, if you have any instance with you, what happens with one email ID, you can create only one instance.
Yes. Okay.
So what you can do, you can create one more instance in London. So what you can do right now, we have that, right? So any configuration changes, I want to move from London to Madrid. So you can use the London version and move the same to your Madrid also.
Yeah. Oh, no. I'm just asking you that I can understand. I mean, the screenshots and all will be different from Madrid, or that's is it okay to learn from London to Madrid?
It's better you learn from the London only. Yeah. Okay. Learn from the London.
Okay.
Once you are aware of London, it will be easy for you to understand the features of Madrid also.
Okay.
Sorry to disturb. Yeah, so you will be including Madrid as well, because as you told me, you will be only using London, but my major requirement is to understand
London and Madrid both. I will be using for any type of
because I want to understand the features of Madrid as well. Major part is Mobile Studio, because right now, if you see, like, everyone, like any company, they'll be implementing Madrid very soon. They'll be updating, and mostly so Mobile Studio will come into picture right now.
Yeah.
So I just wish that even if you include Mobile Studio and Madrid version clearly and use that interface and explain it to us, then it would be really good.
Yeah. So London, Madrid, both I will be working over here. Any other queries, doubt?
No, that's it.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, so again, from the class point of view, we'll have a Monday. So which location you are located?
Sorry.